Hello and welcome. In this video, we will explain how to program the flow repeater terminal and the flow repeater display on the Cerberus FIT FC360 fire panel. The flow repeater terminals and flow repeater displays are used to simplify displaying and operating the fire protection system across the coverage area. They are part of the CNET and can be supplied via the loop or by using an external source. By default, the FT2010 and FT2011 show all events from the fire panel. The FT2011 is only a display without any operation. In contrast, on the FT2010, events can be acknowledged and reset. The FT2010 can additionally be configured to show a list of faulty isolated elements or active technical messages. It can also be programmed to disable the artifier and deactivate or activate the sounders in case of an alarm. Let's now have a look at how to program the FT2010. The FT2011 does not require any further configuration. For the FT2010, several functions can be added in the Element Properties tab. The function List Faults indicates all faults of the fire panel when the left top button of the FT2010 is pressed. List Isolations shows all isolations of the fire panel with the left button in the middle. The function List Technical Messages displays all technical messages with the top button on the right. With the function Activate Deactivate Sounders, the user is able to deactivate or activate the sounders in case of an alarm when the right button in the middle is pressed. The last configuration option is the function Isolate Artifier, which means that if it is activated, the user can disable the outputs configured as remote transmission fire with the button on the lower left. Please note that the key switch needs to be activated in order to use any of the program functions. Finally, apply the configuration to the panel and test the application.